The Palliative Performance Scale has, in the last number of years, with a fair amount of research and publications on that, has become a tool that has several values to it. I think its most valuable aspect is as a simple communication tool amongst professionals. So if I am talking with a home care nurse and she says my patient is at PPS 40%, I know exactly what functional performance level they're at. She doesn't need to explain it to me any more than that. And so it is a very, it's an easy tool to assess somebody. It's very easy and a good uptake in terms of communication as a communication tool. It can be used for, it could be used for workload assessment, you know, like certainly people who are at a PPS of 30% are what we call totally bedbound. They need a lot of nursing care. Somebody at PPS 40 or 50% may need less nursing care, but they're at a higher risk of falling and injuring themselves. So it could be used by palliative programs for kind of workload assessment and measurement. I think is a second thing. And then, because I've had a general interest in prognosis over the years, then we began to look at it in terms of prognostication. And indeed, you know, it, PPS, as well as the Karnofsky and a couple of other performance status tools, do have predictive ability from a survival viewpoint. And so we have created a number of survival tables and its ability then to assist in prognostication is, we've published several papers on that. It's not a be-all and end-all, but it is certainly an element of value. So it's become much, much more widely used, probably most programs in Canada. I think it's translated now into 8 or 9 languages and used in other parts of the world as well. So, yeah, it's a good tool.